Hello, everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security Mini Briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, May 14th, 2024. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then we'll dive into a few vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. All right, so before I dig into today's release, I'd like to compare it to the previous 12 months to really get a feel for how this release stacks up. With that, we have 61 newly published vulnerabilities in today's set. That's down a little bit from our average of around 74 and a half per release. Next, I'll talk about remote code execution vulnerabilities, where we're right at our average of, we have 27 remote code execution vulnerabilities in today's release, and we've been averaging just under 27. Next, I'll talk about scoring, where Microsoft uses an industry standard methodology for rating different vulnerabilities. It's called the Common Vulnerability Scoring System, or CVSS. It's a scale between 1 and 10, where 10 represents the most risk. This month, the highest rated CVSS score in this set is 9.0 on that scale of 10, and that's a little bit lower than what we've been seeing on average over the past year. Now, if we look at the average CVSS score across all 61 vulnerabilities, the average comes out to 7.24, which is about a tenth of a point lower than average, and our average is 7.33. So, as I've mentioned before in these videos, the CVSS score is a starting point when we talk about risk. It doesn't include everything about a vulnerability. It only includes things that allow different software and hardware vendors to be able to easily compare and contrast different vulnerabilities. So some things are in, some things are out when it comes to risk. And when we talk about things that are not part of the score, we're talking about the severity, which is a proprietary to Microsoft rating. It does not include the impact, such as remote code execution or elevation of privilege. It doesn't include things that are publicly disclosed or known to be exploited out in the wild. Again, the CVSS score is a starting point when we talk about risk. So let's move on to a couple other risk factors when we talk about vulnerabilities. The first one here is publicly disclosed vulnerabilities, where we've been averaging right at one for the past year. And in today's set, we have two vulnerabilities that are publicly disclosed. And finally, known to be exploited. There are two vulnerabilities that are known to be exploited at the time of release in today's set. That's just a little bit above our average of around 1.7 over the past year. Next, we'll look at the overview. And those of you familiar with this chart, you'll recognize this, where we put the Windows products towards the bottom. And then as we move up the chart, we get into products that we don't necessarily service every single month. That's certainly the case this month. Windows, depending on the operating system SKU, for our Windows products, we've been averaging mid-30s to mid-40s, depending on the specific operating system. This month, we're right in line with that average. As we move up the chart, we get into Microsoft Office-related software, where there are three updates this month. There are a handful of vulnerabilities in Visual Studio. We'll talk about one of those in just a few minutes. Dynamics 365 has two vulnerabilities. .NET 7.0 and 8.0 have a vulnerability this month. And rounding it out for the chart, Azure Migrate has a vulnerability that's being addressed this month. Okay, let's dive into some of the vulnerabilities from today's release. And we'll start with a important elevation of privilege vulnerability in the Windows DWM core library. This is CVE-2024-30051. This has a base score of 7.8 on that scale of 10. This one, it was publicly disclosed and exploitation has been detected. This has an attack vector that's local. The attack complexity is low. Low privileges are required, but no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. And this is an elevation of privilege vulnerability, and so a threat actor would need to already have a foothold on a system. They would already need to possess some type of valid credentials in order to leverage from whatever credentials they have to, in this case, they could gain system level privileges. The affected software is Windows 10 and 11 on the desktop side, Server 2016, 2019, and Server 2022. Next, I'll talk about an important security feature bypass vulnerability in the Windows MS HTML platform. This is CVE-2024-30040. This was privately disclosed to Microsoft, but exploitation has been detected. This has a base score of 8.8. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. No privileges are required, but user interaction here is required. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. The affected software is Windows 10 and 11, as well as Server 2016, 2019, and Server 2022. Next, I'll talk to CVE-2024-32002. This is a remote code execution vulnerability listed as important severity. Privately disclosed with no exploitation detected. This vulnerability it's being addressed in Visual Studio. The actual vulnerable component is a software called MinGit, and that is consumed by Visual Studio. So in order to address the vulnerable package, Visual Studio is releasing an update this month to address this vulnerability. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is high. No privileges are required, and no user interaction is required either. This is scored at 9.0 on that scale of 10. So this hits that high watermark as far as the highest scored vulnerability in today's set. As far as affected components, it's Microsoft Visual Studio 2017 version 15.9. If you are a Microsoft Premier or Unified Support customer, and you would like to attend the full briefing call where we cover more content and are available to answer questions, you can either work with your CSAM to sign you up, or you can sign yourself up in Services Hub. All right, I want to thank you for joining me today, and I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.